Wow, that would have been.
Yeah, start over.
Yeah. In for research purposes
no,
news.
In for research purposes.
In for research.
You're correcting me. You're my life is over.
I'm helping you.
In for research purposes news.
Research.
Do it again, I don't give a shit. Submitted by Pizza Butter.
Oh, that sounds kind of bomb.
He says it's a JKP reference.
Pizza Butter.
Oh, we said pizza butter.
Sounds familiar.
We created it.
Was it the snake oil thing?
Pizza Butter. It sounds familiar.
I don't memorize shit.
Oh, that's when it was. We did it.
But seriously, you should invent that.
That's what someone in JKP said.
I feel like it was Bart for some reason.
Me too.
I think I've said it too. But we do all improv stuff, so I don't remember what we say.
Yeah, but pizza flavored stuff never tastes like pizza. You ever had pizza-flavored Pringles or chips or anything? It never tastes like
But it tastes good.
It's never there, though.
Then call it a oregano tomato butter. I don't care.
Those chips are always so unsatisfying. It's like this will taste like nachos. And I'm like, oh, yeah. Oh.
I like how you fall for it every time.
I do. Every new flavor, I fall for it. I'm like, ooh, this one's chicken and waffles. Oh.
Candles are on point, though. They always smell they like always the thing they like say.
I wish you could eat the candles.
It's not fucking Willy Wonka here, all right? It's not going to taste like what
the schnozberries don't taste like schnozberries.
A woman describes her experience with trying 6 different ways to reach an orgasm.
6? Wow. I want to hear them.
Clitoral, G-spot.
Butthole.
There's a butthole G-spot, orgasm? Though.
Titty orgasm.
There's also
oh,
a G-spot
yeah.
in your little...
And what I've heard is the biggest female
It's the same
orgasm.
Spot. It just gets hit from different angles.
Well, then I would say I would count that as 3.
Oh, that's true. Three.
So I heard the biggest female orgasm as... I've heard...
Joke's over!
It's not a joke. It's real.
It's dead.
Orgasm. It's not me. No, I'm...
Not no more. Put it out. Put it out the fire.
I'm
winner?
No, I've heard that the biggest female orgasm happens through the mouth. I actually heard that. I read that. I really did.
It would have been funnier.
That sounds like a fact.
It's a medical joke.
Yeah, if you would have nailed the verbiage, it would have been funnier.
Go say it again.
When they finish, they vomit.
When they finish, they come real hard.
The old timey camera.
You mean from kissing?
Yeah.
I'll explain that.
More kissing.
This author here, she's a Vice author, her name is Allie, and she's just saying that not all women orgasm the same way.
You don't have to tell me that.
Aw, sister.
You mean we're not all equal?
Yeah, she's saying that depending on who you speak to, like, there could be, like, a wide range of how many different orgasms women can reach, but right here, for today, we're just gonna be talking about 6 ways.
There's more
like
than
lot.
6?
There's 6 out of 85 or something.
See, that's why if a guy thinks he knows because his last girlfriend, like, he could, you know, do it really good every time, like, they still need to be trained, like, on you because you're different.
How did you train
me? Yeah, she's saying that.
How did you train me?
I was just like, go lower or go higher. Or
oh, I see what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes girls like different things on their bodies.
Totally. You said go higher, right? Go higher. All the way up to the mouth. You know what I'm talking about? Gets her every time.
You're so funny. Let's see how much sex you have.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, so apparently there's between 2 to 12 types of female orgasm.
What?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Chicks can barely come once.
This is Allie.
Okay, that's just a pen knife.
You mean 12 different types of doing it through your body?
She'll talk about it, don't you worry.
Well, I'm trying to figure out. There's 12 different ways of doing it
through your body. You'll never figure out. A woman's
Shut the
body.
12 different ways of how to reach an orgasm.
Okay.
There's even
what is there to not understand?
Like sound, like you could get like auditory.
Can you just start talking about them? Because we keep talking about the number, but we don't really go into any of them.
I've been trying to go into it.
Okay.
Would you just get to it already?
Yeah, hurry up, Tiff. God damn it.
How come I wake up from a dream without anyone touching me and I orgasm?
Because you're awesome.
See, that's one of them too.
Is it? See?
Well, let's
I get a point. That's one of them.
That's a wet dream.
I never had one.
The first one is clitoral. So the clitoris is supplied mainly by the pineal nerve, the vagina mainly by the pelvic nerve, and the cervix mainly by the hypogastric, pelvic, and vagus nerves. While stimulating each of these regions can by itself produce orgasms, the combined stimulation of all 3 regions, which is a blended orgasm, has an additive effect. So this is all said by Dr. Beverly.
Why are you not doing all of these to me?
I know, I feel inadequate.
A clitoral orgasm too? A clitoral, cervical, what's the third one?
A vagina, anal, plastic, cervical one.
What the?
And tonsil.
So, well, for now we're just gonna be talking about
tonsil.
Is body parts like space rocks and like moons and planets and shit? Where like if the doctor who finds it gets to name it after himself? Like, was there a doctor named vulva and like, you know, like clitoris and shit?
I think most body parts are Latin words because it's kind of like a secret language for people that were educated.
Yeah, you didn't know that? Yeah.
No,
fuck everyone knew that.
And also, did the guy that named the vulva like even know about the vulva? Cause like,
well, cause his last name was that. That's what I'm saying. They like they put their stamp on the shit that they make.
But, and like, your car sounds like a vagina name. Just saying. Vulva.
She got her boyfriend to help her through all of these experiments. So here's her and her boyfriend.
Oh, he looks so depressed. Did she fake it for him though? You know what I'm saying?
It was all for research purposes.
She's like, honey, we gotta fuck a lot.
She's like, oh, you got it. You totally got that one.
That one sucked.
So she says that the clitoral was not the best orgasm, but doggy style is her favorite position because she can touch herself while she's getting vaginal penetration.
So that's still a clitoral orgasm because she has to stimulate.
But now she's combining.
She's combining it.
What is this in? Is this in like the Daily Mail or something?
No, this is Vice.
I just think
I just love the idea that her parents, it's like, hey mom and dad, we're in Vice.
Hey mom and dad, I'm a journalist. Yeah, check out my research.
We had an article. It's on the internet. It went viral.
I've heard of this before, but I feel like it's so uncomfortable to do that while that's happening. Like it.
You need a shoulder to prop you up, right?
Or like.
Usually you got your two front paws.
No, like this.
Pause.
Yeah. It's already moving your clitoris, you know, and then it's just you have to. I don't know. It's too much work.
The second type of orgasm is the G-spot. Right,
please explain to him where it is.
The G-spot is found.
That's you gotta do the come here. That's where it's at.
I'm ready for the next video.
Okay, so the G-spot is found at the anterior wall of the vagina, along the urethra, near the 12 o'clock position, with the woman lying on her back, stimulating deep lying tissue that surrounds the urethra by pressing against the internal vaginal surface with a come here motion.
Are you getting this?
Was most likely to produce orgasm.
According
to the science of orgasm. So for her, this area is more sensitive than others, but not enough to make her orgasm, only when she stimulates her clitoris, but that just turns into a blended orgasm.
Well, can I just say though that she might have not felt it with that guy because but like
different shapes.
Different shapes because I think that like if you have a girthier dick, like it could hit the G-spot easier than other dicks that maybe aren't so girthy, and then you're like, oh, I never knew this was possible.
So for research, she has to find a short and stumpy.
Yes, she should find a more chode-looking dick or something.
Short and stumpy. She's like, honey, I gotta do it. It's for research.
It's part of my job as a journalist.
The third one is the cervical orgasm. You guys know where the cervix is?
Yes.
That sounds deep.
All the way in the back. It is deep.
That sounds like some baby stuff.
Sounds like out of my range. Yeah.
Oh, bless your heart.
To reach a cervical orgasm.
Yeah, I shoot far. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you can position.
We got evidence of that.
Let me tell you how to.
His name's Taika.
Yeah.
It says here that the couple should use a position in which there's deep penetration of the penis. One position is with the woman lying on her back with their legs elevated around the man's back or neck.
Picture us, Tiff.
No, stop it. I don't want to. Why would you do that to me?
Yeah, you already have me in the position. I'm on my back.
Okay, so anyway, so then.
That's really nice.
This random woman here is penetrated. So deep penetration is more likely if this random woman
pulls my tattoo's
her
on
legs
the
toward the body
on my forearms.
Placing a pillow under the woman's lower back can also allow deep stimulation. This is all according to
or the just forehead. Find a guy with a bigger dick. Just so
I wouldn't recommend the pillow thing. I would put a towel over there because that shit gets soaked and you don't want to sleep on that.
Oh my god!
Well, who's bragging now? Jesus,
so it's Allie. A natural thing that happens.
So for Allie,
you give him a squirt every time, right, bud?
No.
So for Allie in particular, she said that instead of feeling pressure, she felt too much pressure on her cervix and she wasn't really able to achieve.
Nikki doesn't like this bitch.
Like,
I don't.
Taking notes like, while she's doing this.
Apparently, in a study out of 132 women.
She should just say, I don't know how to take a dick.
Fuck, dude.
Damn, you're savage.
This is my chick right here, bud.
I'm like, that's your wife, bro, not even your chick.
I know, she's my freaking
wife.
Well,
she keeps going into descriptions like, yeah, and she's like, I didn't really like it that much because it too much pressure. Like, what?
Yeah, good for you. Good for you. Stick up for yourself.
Sucks.
You're like, yeah, girlfriend. Nah, I'm not with you anymore. Nah.
Yeah.
She doesn't know how to take a dick.
I love it,
so
dude.
So she was just saying, though, that she's not alone in this because in a study out of 132 women, only 46% orgasm to cervical stimulation. It was 86% vaginal, 98%.
Did they all have the same dick? See, that's why you can't do a group study like that. There has to be the same dick fucking all 140 of them. There's too many variables in this study.
Have a great life.
All right, the fourth way is a urethral orgasm.
What orgasm?
Urethral orgasm.
Oh, okay.
It's like with a teeny tiny dick's fucking your urethra.
Oh.
Yeah, what is that?
So here it says, theoretically, if you stimulate the small area of sensitive tissue around the urethral opening that lies between your vagina and clitoris, you're probably stimulating your clitoris too, which is what leads to orgasm.
I'm learning too much.
I still feel like that's the same as a clitoris.
Yeah, because they're saying that this is because your clit is mostly internal.
Yeah, it's like different forms of clitoris.
It's like the backside of your clitoris.
Yeah, it's like upside, downside, sideways.
Yeah, that's a fucking dance move. Yeah. Upside, downside, sideways.
It's like different clitoris stimulation. Because no matter what, it's like the prerequisite. Like while you're getting the G-spot, you need the clitoris one, or like it's kind of like that has to always happen?
No.
Yeah, well, for Allie here,
she's like, I'm back in health class, dude. This ruins the mystery for me.
It does.
It should help you.
No.
Guys should know that their dick's not gonna hit all the spots.
Yep.
They're gonna hit like one spot, maybe two spots, but you're not, there's a lot of spots that you could hit. That's the good news.
Use your hands, man.
If you can hit one, you can hit another one.
That is not just your dick.
Come on, Casey.
All the previous
Casey, what the fuck, Casey?
Just buy her a vibrator.
Holy shit, Casey. You have two hands, too.
Yeah, bro, come on.
Come on, Casey.
Let go of the camera.
Jesus Christ, Casey.
I'm not allowed to because I got calluses.
All right, so Allie here, she said that it took a while to get used to it, the whole like urethral stimulation, and she only orgasmed when she stopped thinking about the placement and she just relaxed. So she's skeptical whether it really was a urethral orgasm or if it was just a clitoral stimulation.
Herself.
Yeah,
so it was a brain orgasm.
Yeah, it's just too much in her brain.
The
brain
women know this, like if your brain is somewhere else, you will not achieve an orgasm.
Laundry undone.
Yeah, it's true.
Probably thinking about the laundry, probably thinking about what you're making for dinner that night.
Yep.
Probably thinking about doing the dishes.
Yeah. Cut it, all
right? Right.
Hey, erase that. Nope.
Am I speaking for all women right now or what?
No, hey.
Well, you could tell them who did the dishes and the laundry the other day.
Oh, did he do them the right way?
I feel betrayed. I feel betrayed by you. We have trust.
All right, so the fifth orgasm is the sleep orgasm, which you mentioned. And so
it just happened the other day.
The one that doesn't involve Steve.
It's the only way she can come, guys. She has to go to sleep.
The areas of the brain that get activated during physical contact can also get activated during sleep and from intense mental focus. It triggers the same physiological responses that we experience during waking orgasms.
That's like meditation sex.
I was having a dream about you.
That's like, well, good.
But we had to test out all these different types of condoms, and that's what happened in the dream.
That's
so for
cool.
Allie, in order to get herself mentally prepared, she watched this British soap opera called EastEnders, and it features it features an incredibly erotic man.
Pick what you dream about.
And so she
dreamt about it.
Yeah, so she went to sleep horny. Yep.
So that's the whole point. She's trying to mentally prepare herself to be horny. She ended up showering with her boyfriend. And then she went to sleep sexually frustrated. 3 hours later, she wakes up to orgasming from a
Right. She put that just to say that she did it. You can't plan that.
She says that for her, she already orgasms in her sleep about once a month.
Oh, okay.
But for her, it's something.
Oh, okay.
Fires up Pride and Prejudice, goes to bed, and she comes. Like, what the fuck?
This is heroin.
Fucking depressing ass.
Yeah.
Why does every photo have her doing duck lips?
She wants to make her face look skinny.
Like, all these photos are kind of like a blog post type of thing. Like, she's telling a story with her photos. I don't know why duck lips, though, for sure.
Just remember that Nikki said she can't take a dick.
All right, for the last
orgasm. A shirt.
It's a mental orgasm. So imaginary orgasms are things that women are capable of experiencing.
Wow.
I've thought that.
Yeah,
imaginary?
So, yeah, I thought myself into it, but I was high, so.
Oh. So you thought yourself into an orgasm?
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
Girls are powerful.
Dude, the mind is so powerful.
It's like,
girls are.
It's like when you're acting and you like remember the, it's like a substitution thing.
That's scary.
Like where you can remember what it feels like to have an orgasm, so it feels like you're having an orgasm.
Yep.
Well, don't do it right now, Jesus Christ.
Girls are natural method actors.
Yeah, well, for Allie here though, she watched porn for 40 minutes. She felt slightly aroused, but she couldn't reach an orgasm. Just by visual.
Damn, she watched like a whole movie.
I was watching this strange sex documentary thing, and there's like a group thing where it's called Thinking Off. And they actually have classes where like people are lying in a circle and you're all like this, and like the teacher
guides you into orgasm. Like,
oh, cool.
Yeah, and like people are just, you're not even touching yourself or anything, and like people are just awesome. Like having orgasm, and they say that like it lasts longer than a regular orgasm.
Guys too, guys are just coming away.
Right? Guys are coming in this guy's sultry, smooth voice. Right? He's like, come for me now, I want you to come for me. Like it's Morgan Freeman in there. Mm.
They even have like hypnosis orgasms and shit. Like,
I'm not fucking with that.
Like, and then they interview the people, and the people are like, yeah, I don't even have regular orgasms anymore at all. I just, thinking off is so much better. So
dang.
They just, that's all they do is they're just like, just thinking off all day.
That's like when people are plugged into the Matrix and they're getting shot.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, yeah. Jerking the fucking things that they're holding for no reason. Yeah, I love that.
You know how messy it would be if it was all guys in that room?
Fuck, that's gross.